Hello, little cubs. I hope you're all doing well, and welcome back to Storytime with Mama Bear. Tonight's video will be more Aesop's Fables, and I have another special guest to read some with me. Today, I have the beautiful and wonderful Rena, a fellow subscriber. I hope you all enjoy our little collaboration. If you do enjoy this video, please be sure to give it a like and share with your family and friends. And be sure to subscribe for more story time with Mama Bear. Please enjoy. The Astrologer. A man who lived a long time ago believed that he could read the future in the stars. He called himself an astrologer and spent his time at night gazing at the sky. One evening, he was walking along the open road outside the village. His eyes were fixed on the stars. He thought he saw there that the end of the world was at hand, when all at once, down he went into a hole full of mud and water. There he stood up to his ears in the muddy water and madly clawing at the slippery sides of the hole in his effort to climb out. His cries for help soon brought the villagers running. As they pulled him out of the mud, one of them said, "You pretend to read the future in the stars, and yet you fail to see what is at your feet. This may teach you to pay more attention to what is right in front of you, and let the future take care of itself."
"What use is it," said another, "to read the stars when you can't see what's right here on earth?"
Take care of the little things, and the big things will take care of themselves.
The Old Lion. A lion had grown very old. His teeth were worn away. His limbs could no longer bear him, and the king of beasts was very pitiful indeed as he lay gasping underground, about to die. Where now his strength, his former graceful beauty? Now a boar spied him and rushed at him, gored him with his yellow tusk. A bull trampled him with his heavy hooves. Even now a contemptible ass let fly his heels and brayed his insults in the face of the lion. It is cowardly to attack the defenseless, though he can be an enemy.
The Bear and the Bees. A bear, roaming the woods in search of berries, happened on a fallen tree in which a swarm of bees had stored their honey. The bear began to nose around the log very carefully to find out if the bees were at home. Just then, one of the swarm came home from the clover field with a load of sweets. Guessing what the bear was after, the bee flew at him, stung him sharply, and then disappeared into the hollow log. The bear lost his temper in an instant and sprang upon the log tooth and claw to destroy the nest. But this only brought out the whole swarm. The poor bear had to take to his heels, and he was able to save himself only by diving into a pool of water. It is wiser to bear a single injury in silence than to provoke a thousand by flying into a rage.
The Wolf and the Crane. A wolf had been feasting too greedily, and a bone had stuck crosswise in his throat. He could get it neither up nor down, and of course he had not eat a thing. Naturally, there was an awful state of affairs for a greedy wolf. So away he hurried to the crane. He was sure that she, with her long neck and bill, would easily be able to reach the bone and pull it out. I will reward you very handsomely, said the wolf, if you pull that bone out for me. The crane, as you can imagine, was very uneasy about putting her head in a wolf's throat. But she was grasping in nature. So she did what the wolf asked her to do. When the wolf felt that the bone was gone, he started to walk away. But what about my reward? Called the crane anxiously. What? Snarled the wolf, whirling around. Haven't you got it? Isn't it enough that I let you take your head out of my mouth without snapping it off? Expect no reward for serving the wicked.